Good evening, everybody. We're here to discuss and talk about something quite somber and something quite disturbing. For those of you who've been following the global headlines out of India since the what's come to be known as the December 16th gang rape, the gang rape of a young woman who came to be known as Nirbhaya or the fearless one, sexual violence has been at the top of our national conversation. But what about all the Nirbhayas who do not live in our cities, whose stories never make it to the front pages of our newspapers or to the lead stories of our television channels? Today, we are here to talk about somebody who suffered and fought exactly like Nirbhaya did, even before Nirbhaya became a national headline. You saw excerpts of Bitiya's story in that video that just played, but for anyone who needs a kind of recapitulation of exactly what happened, this is the story of a young minor Dalit girl who was raped by upper caste men who filmed her on video, who filmed the rape. They filmed the rape, the act of sexual violence on video, and then sold that video in the village for a dollar. And here we have on stage with us the extraordinary girl who's come to be known as Bitiya. Bitiya, as some of you know, means daughter, because she is in many ways India's daughter. And her extraordinary mother, and a local activist, Maheshwari, who's been working with them, and they're here to share the story of what it's meant for young Bitiya to fight the good fight. Rajo, aapse shuru karungi. For those who don't understand Hindi, what I'm going to do is talk to them in Hindi and then just translate it bit by bit. बिटिया बैठी हैं हमारे साथ आप उनकी माँ हैं जो बिटिया के साथ हुआ वो किसी माँ के लिए तो बिल्कुल दिल तोड़ने वाली बात है दिल टूटने वाली बात है आप लोगों ने तय किया कि हमें न्याय मिलना चाहिए हाँ हम लड़ेंगे लेकिन जब आपने लड़ना शुरू किया तो आपने ये भी पाया कि ना पुलिस ने मदद की बिटिया का जो स्कूल था उसको स्कूल से निकाल दिया गांव वालों ने दबाव डाला कि ये केस वापस ले लीजिए तो आप थोड़ा यहाँ जो लोग बैठे हैं उनको बताइए कि किस तरह के दबाव आपके ऊपर आए और क्या क्या दबाव आए और क्या प्रेशर सबसे ज्यादा लगा आप बताइए मैं पकड़ती
हाँ जी ये हमारे ऊपर जब केस हुआ था तो हमें गांव वालों ने बहुत दबाव दिया नाजायज दबाव दिया कि आप फैसला कर लो पैसा ले लो हमने पैसे को मना कर दिया बिल्कुल हमने ठुकरा दिया कि हमें पैसा नहीं चाहिए क्योंकि हमारे साथ आज हमारी बेटी के साथ अन्याय हुआ है तो हमारे पास और भी बेटी हैं और के साथ भी हो सकता है तो हम ऐसे पैसा लेते तो हमारे साथ और भी घटनाएं हो जाएंगी तो फिर हम क्या करेंगे हम
तो आपको रिश्वत देने की कोशिश
निस्वत देने की कोशिश करें हमने निस्वत को मना कर दिया बिल्कुल हमें निस्वत नहीं चाहती है
सो बिटियाज मदर इज सेइंग दैट शी वाज ऑफर्ड अ ब्राइब शी वाज ऑफर्ड मनी so that they would not fight their case. But she said that that was absolutely unacceptable. And there are many girls everywhere in India who are fighting like Bitiya has. And you are telling me that many children, who have been fighting with your child, and for those children, you have said, no, we will fight. We will fight. We are not afraid of
fighting. We will fight. And our man is also on this side. But when we will fight, we will fight. Your
man, Bitiya's father, उन्होंने ये वीडियो देखा आई जस्ट वांट टू टेल पीपल दैट बिटियाज फादर हु डाइड ऑफ अ हार्ट अटैक एक्चुअली डिस्कवर्ड व्हाट हैपेंड टू हिज डॉटर व्हेन दिस वीडियो वाज बीइंग पॉन्ड इन द लोकल विलेज स्टोर फॉर अ डॉलर एंड ही सॉ दिस रेप वीडियो एंड दैट्स हाउ ही डिस्कवर्ड व्हाट हैपेंड टू हिज डॉटर पिता इनके जो पिता थे इन्होंने वीडियो देख के समझा कि क्या हुआ तो पुलिस ने क्या किया
पुलिस ने कुछ नहीं किया पुलिस ने तो पुलिस भी खाली निस्वत खाती रही पुलिस ने कुछ नहीं करा हमारे लिए और जो हमारा वकील था वो भी पैसा खाता रहा उसने भी कुछ नहीं करा हमारे लिए
बिटिया आपसे पूछूंगी सबसे मुश्किल मतलब आपके मन में से तो ये बात कभी नहीं निकलेगी एक तरह से आपकी पूरी जिंदगी बदल गई लेकिन स्कूल में से जब आपको कहा कि आप स्कूल से निकल जाइए क्या वो सबसे ज्यादा मुश्किल लगा क्या मुश्किल लगा सबसे ज्यादा इसमें
ये मुश्किल लगा कि जब उन्होंने हमें कहा कि स्कूल से निकल जाओ और मैं पढ़ना चाहती थी कहा कि और लड़कियों पे भी तुम्हारा असर पड़ेगा
उन्होंने कहा कि बाकी लड़कियों पे आपका बुरा असर पड़ेगा हाँ। मतलब ऐसे आपको आपको ट्रीट किया जैसे गलती आपकी हो
हाँ लेकिन गलती मेरी नहीं थी
बिटिया सेज दैट द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट थिंग फॉर हर हैज बीन द फैक्ट दैट शी वाज आस्क्ड टू गेट आउट ऑफ द स्कूल वेयर शी स्टडीड एंड द मेन हु डिड दिस टू हर their relatives, other people in the village told Bitiya that you're going to be a bad influence on other girls. Bitiya, gussa bahut aata hoga. Dard to hoti hai, lekin gussa nahi aata. Batao.
Gussa bhi aata hai.
और अभी जो कोर्ट है उसमें जिन्होंने जिन आदमियों ने आपके साथ किया वो अभी उनको उनके साथ कुछ पनिशमेंट नहीं हुआ उनको कुछ पनिशमेंट नहीं हुआ तो कभी लगता है कि चलो लड़ाई छोड़ दे हमें नहीं लड़ना हम अपनी ज़िंदगी ले लें कि मन में लगता है कि हम यहाँ पे न्याय लेके ही रहेंगे
हाँ मन में ये लगता है कि हम न्याय लेकर ही रहेंगे
सो शी इज सेइंग कम व्हाट मे आई वांट जस्टिस एंड आई विल कीप फाइटिंग बिटिया गाँव वालों ने किस किस तरह की बातें आपको बोली
गांव वालों ने यही फैसले की बात की कि फैसला कर लो
और आपके बारे में आपने कहा आपको दोषी मानते थे
जी हाँ
क्या बोलते थे बिटिया
यही कहते थे कि फैसला करने को ही बोलते थे
पर आपने कहा ना जैसे आपको बोला कि आप दूसरों के ऊपर बुरा इन्फ्लुएंस करेंगे तो जब स्कूल में बच्चे क्या तंग करते थे बुरी बातें बोलते थे
बच्चे नहीं बस सर टीचर लोग बोलते थे एडमिशन को मना कर देता उन्होंने कि तुम्हारा असर इन पर पड़ेगा
teacher bolte the so it's not the children but the teachers at the school who basically treated the victim or in this case the victim and a survivor I don't like the word victim the survivor as if she were an accused bitiya aapne kya sapna dekha hai apne liye kya karna chahti hain aap
pad ke kuch banna chahti hu
pad ke kuch banna chahti hu I want to study and be somebody that is her dream आप अपनी बेटी के लिए क्या सपना देखती हैं?
अपनी बेटी के लिए मैं लड़ाई लड़ना चाहती हूँ और मेरी लड़की किसी लाख हो अपने पैरों पर खड़ी हो जो हमारा भी खर्चा चले और हमारी बच्ची भी पढ़ती है
हमने एक बात इसमें नहीं की वो जात की बात है ये जिन्होंने किया क्योंकि हम भूल जाते हैं वी फॉरगेट इन दिस कंट्री दैट व्हेन कास्ट एंड क्लास एंड जेंडर एक्चुअली कोलाइड इनजस्टिस गेट्स मल्टीप्लाइड We forget that in our cities, we forget that in our cocoons of security. What happened here was a minor girl was raped, but she was also a Dalit girl raped by the upper caste men of her village. तो जो दूसरे जात के लोग थे, जो अपने आप को ऊपरी समझते हैं, ठाकुर हैं, तो उन्होंने किस तरह का भेदभाव किया?
उन्होंने भेदभाव ये किया कि ये गरीब आदमी ये कुछ नहीं कर सकते, ये पैसा लेके और ये पैसे का दबाव देंगे हम इनको तो ये पैसा ले लें गरीब आदमी ये हमारा कुछ नहीं कर सकते
राजू आपसे पूछूंगी आप माँ हैं हिम्मत कहाँ से मिलती है ये लड़ाई रखने की आपको और बिटिया को आपके आदमी भी नहीं रहे आप एक तरह से अकेले हैं बिटिया की दादाजी बैठे हैं यहाँ पर वो मदद करते हैं लेकिन कहाँ से हिम्मत मिलती है कहाँ से हिम्मत मिलती है
ये हमें हिम्मत हमें कुछ सस्ता वाली दे रही हैं हमारी दीदी लोग और हमें आपकी भी वही मिल रही है थोड़ी हिम्मत इसलिए लड़ाई लड़ना चाहते हैं हम कुछ नहीं चाहिए हमें हमें लड़ाई चाहिए आगे के लिए
बिटिया आखिर में आपसे पूछूंगी कि बहुत से लड़कियों के साथ इस देश में होता है जो आपके साथ हुआ आप उन सारी लड़कियों को क्या कहना चाहेंगी आज क्या आपका उनको क्या संदेशा है कि किस तरह वो वही बहादुरी दिखाएं जो आपकी और आपने परिवार ने दिखाई है क्या बोलना चाहेंगी लड़कियों के साथ ये जो बीतती है जो आपके साथ बीती कहाँ से हिम्मत मिलती है आपको बिटिया
ये हिम्मत हमारे मेरे पिता से मिली मुझे
मेरे आपके पिताजी से
परिवार से हमारे और ये बनांगना वाली दीदी से
महेश्वरी जी जो बैठी है
जी
महेश्वरी जी अगर आप कुछ आखिर में बोलें कि कैसे ये परिवार ने झेला है शायद आपके पास माइक है हाँ
जिस गांव की बिटिया रहने वाली है वो ठाकुर बाहुल गांव है इतना दबदबा है वहाँ का जो इतिहास अभी तक रहा है कि वाल्मीकि जो भी दलित लड़कियाँ हैं उनके साथ आए दिन ऐसे रेप करते रहते थे और पैसे के दम पे वो दबा देती थी केसों को लेकिन जो हमने इस केस में देखा कि इन लोगों के ऊपर दबाव काफ़ी पड़े
लेकिन ये
झुके नहीं और इन्होंने बराबर हिम्मत करके सामना किया पहले तो जब हम पहुँचे जब हमारी संस्था पहुंची तो इनकी एफआईआर हो चुकी थी लेकिन इनके अंदर एक जो संस्था का होता है कि जब केस लड़ने वाला ही ढीला पड़ जाता तो संस्था क्या कर सकती है
जी।
लेकिन इनकी ताकत देख के हम लोगों को इतनी ताकत मिली
जी।
कि हम इनके साथ खड़े हुए और उनको कोई ठाकुरों का उस समय शुरू में इनके ऊपर दबाव पड़ा कि हम ये कर देंगे, तुम्हारे भाई को मार देंगे।
और महेश्वरी जी, ये भी हमें याद रखना चाहिए कि आदमी लोग भी कई बारी बहुत सपोर्ट देते हैं। कई ऐसी फैमिलीज होती हैं जो आदमी नहीं सपोर्ट देते, लेकिन रजो ने जैसे कहा कि बिटिया के फादर जो नहीं रहे, और शायद दादाजी भी यहाँ हैं। दादाजी कहाँ हैं, थोड़े खड़े हुई है दादाजी। दिस इज बिटियाज ग्रैंड फादर, आइए। दिस इज बिटियाज ग्रैंड फादर हु हैज बीन फाइटिंग फॉर देम थ्रू आउट, एंड आई थिंक वी मस्ट अपलॉड इट व्हेन मेन पुट देयर एंटायर वेट behind families. And I will say to, मैं सिर्फ इतना कहना चाहूँगी बिटिया, रजो और महेश्वरी और दादाजी आपको, आप बैठिए, कि हम आपसे सबसे इंस्पिरेशन ड्रॉ करते हैं. As we listen to their story, I also want to remind people the December 16th gang rape is still fresh in our memory. And we have here actually the parents, the mother of Nirbhaya. Asha ji, आप कहाँ हैं? आशा जी कहीं? आई वॉज टोल्ड दैट द पेरेंट्स आर हियर एंड वी विल बी सॉर्ट ऑफ इंट्रोड्यूसिंग देम इन अ वाइल एंड ब्रिंगिंग देम अप इन टू द कॉन्वर्सेशन. निर्भयाज पेरेंट्स आर ऑल्सो हियर एंड वील जस्ट बी गेटिंग देम इन टू द कॉन्वर्सेशन. थैंक यू सो मच. लेट्स हैव अ बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर द करेज ऑफ दिस यंग गर्ल बिटिया. Question before all of us today is, what has changed in the last 3 years since Nirbhaya made the headlines? And I think what's also worth remembering is that the story you just heard, Bitiya's story, actually took place well before the Delhi gang rape. And there are stories like this, as you saw in those statistics, that unfold every single day. And right now we're only talking about reported incidents of sexual violence. We haven't even begun to scratch the surface of what sometimes I like to call the most dangerous space of all for women, and that is their home and their circle of trust. And we will be speaking about that as well. Here with me are four people who have worked very, very extensively with the issue of sexual violence, helping survivors and victims in their quest for justice. Madhavi Kuckreja, if I may start with you, as somebody who knows Bitiya's case very well, what's really disturbing to hear is that the court, and it took a lot of courage for them to go to court. The police, as we heard the mother saying, was not helpful at all. The court just acquitted these men. There's a video. This rape is on video. How can these men still be acquitted? And how do you motivate a family to actually take this case to court when even rape on camera cannot get you a conviction? It's on. Not on. Just pass her yours, Vibha.
We've broken the silence. But along with breaking the silence, and because of breaking the silence, this young girl in Bijnor and her father can fight this battle. But I think along with breaking the silence, there's a huge, all the stakeholders that are involved. You're fighting a judiciary, you're fighting a police. And while we've made many, many leaps and bounds, everybody still is in the framework of patriarchy. everyone is in the framework of doing mediation. Everyone feels that, you know, I mean, it's not about justice and compensation. It's about mediation, whether it's in domestic violence or sexual assault, and about compromise.
But how do you explain an acquittal in a case like this? This is an open and shut case.
But you know, the details of her district court, the details of her own lawyer, that was a lawyer chosen by the Valmiki community to represent them, who spent the last year trying to put pressure on them to compromise for like 10 lakhs of rupees or whatever.
Yeah, so we heard the mother saying that they offered us bribes and we refused to accept
them. So, I mean, he obviously also got his part of that pot of money. So, I mean, the whole issue is that, okay, you've taken up this case. It's in the media for a while. It's sensational. But the long struggle, the nitty-gritty of that battle and fighting that court case every single time they go there, when you're fighting your own lawyer who's kind of making that video disappear, and everybody is taking what is it? There's an Indian word called Hindi, it's saying chuski. I mean, the whole thing is everyone is having, while they're fighting it for you, that they're taking some maza out of this.
It's a salacious, voyeuristic delight in somebody else's horrific personal violation. I just want to bring in...
And I just want to add a little bit. It's just, I mean, the point is that you're fighting a caste battle also.
I just said that when caste and class and gender collide, injustice is, you know, so multiplied many times.
It's that triple burden that someone carries. And there's poverty along the way also.
Yeah.
I mean, that family still collected gobar. I mean, they collected the defecation of cows, of human beings still, I mean... Till a few days ago.
You know, Madhavi, as Bitiya's mother said, that they all thought we are poor and therefore we can do nothing. Now, Menaka, as a lawyer in the Supreme Court who looks at many of these cases, I just want to weigh in on whether you feel cynical or optimistic. And I ask you this because, you know, I was at a Women in the World Summit in New York and I got into this huge fight with Leslie Udwin, whom, as everybody knows here, had made India's daughter. And I said, you know, not to take away from, of course, the sexual violence that we're battling, but you missed the point that December 16th was an inflection point and it's become a moment of hope. Gender's finally a mainstream conversation. But then I listened to Bitiya and I'm wondering, was I over-optimistic? Has anything changed?
Well, look, I mean, the promise of the Constitutional Democratic Republic of India, the promise to Bitiya and to her family, if we had kept it, one wouldn't have had this traditional act of violence, right? Upper caste men raping a lower caste woman is historically been the norm in India.
Yeah.
So in many ways, constitutional democracy in India has failed her. Mm-hmm. And the court system has failed her. The court system continues to be the colonizer's court system, except who is the colonizer has just changed slightly. Yeah. Right now, am I optimistic? Is there any cause of hope? Yes, there's growing responsiveness. Right, within the media, there's a discontent amongst young Indians. They're aspirational. Young Indian women seek freedom, seek self-determination, seek autonomy. There's sensitivity, growing sensitivity within the courts. Now, this is a trial court and a lawyer by all accounts and maybe a judge and certainly a police that is uniformly in this country, unresponsive, insensitive, and really, who should have been the interface between loss and justice.
That's the perfect cue to go to Vibha, because Vibha, your film that won the National Award actually spent a lot of time with the police. And you are perhaps among the few who actually believe that the police has changed. But you know, you just heard Bitiya's mother saying that the police did absolutely nothing for us. And you know, the horror I have seen many victims and survivors of rape try to get an FIR registered in a police station, and the kind of questions you're asked, the way you're made to feel dirty for the dirt that has been inflicted on you. Yes. Do you really believe that the police is more sensitized today?
I am just an ordinary daughter of India. And when the film started, I was searching for answers for my own gender. So I did not go in with an agenda. It was a cry of my conscience. When we entered, when we had gained access to the police control and command room, actually the three-person crew, we did not even treat them as human beings. But what we realized is they are a reflection of us. So if we had biases at home, if there were feelings of hurt, anger, disgust, that is how they felt. If domestic violence is a gharelu mamla, well, that cop is not registering the crime. That's when we realized that we need to look at ourselves and these biases that run so deep. Unless we don't change, whether we don't bring change at home, you know what? Let's forget about them. What are we doing?
So, you know, that's so important, and I want to get into it in a moment from now, because actually more than 90% of women in India, and this is according to the National Crime Records Bureau, this is an official statistic, know the man who has sexually abused them.
Yes.
The sexual abuser is mostly not a stranger. And that is something to think about in a country which refuses to recognize marital rape as something punishable by law. But first, let me bring in Govind Singh Rathore. Govind, you're with the Sambhali Trust, but you personally saw your mother at the receiving end of abuse. And that, in a sense, transformed you. So can you talk a little bit about that and how it shaped you for all time to come?
Well, I was... I can think as far as 9 years old or so.
Yeah.
And my father had been chronic alcoholic, and he would come home every night and hit my mother. I used to hide under the bed of my parents with my dog, and I used to give my mother a plate and spoon, and I used to tell her, "Ki mummy, as soon as he touches you, you start ringing the bell, and I will come out of the bed and help you." Sometimes I used to fall asleep because I had to go to school in the mornings. And it was, and then, you know, one morning I woke up and she wouldn't talk to me while making breakfast for school. So I asked her, "Mummy, bolo, please say something, say something." She wouldn't say anything until when I came back from school, I figured out that she had a broken jaw because my father had hit her so badly that night that broke her jaw. And learning from that, at the age of, I was engaged at the age of 14, and at the age of 20, I was married. And
by choice or by force?
It was not by choice. I was arranged married. And at the age of 20, my mother got me married to my wife, and she came in my life and started running our family business, which is related to tourism. And by the age of 23, we were blessed by a child. And it was then when I said to my wife, I said, "Mukta, it is time that you take care of the family business. And I do something for women in similar circumstances as of my mother and of my grandmother."
Yeah.
See, my grandmother was only 18. My grandmother was only 12 when she got married to my grandfather, who is 45. Gosh. And she was bought for 1,800 rupees. Because there are so less girls in the desert where I come from, that you have to buy your wife, you have to buy your bride. There are no girl children left in the desert.
Well, you know, we need men like you in this space. And thank you for sharing what... of course, must be so painful for a 9-year-old child to hide under the bed and see his mother being clobbered by his father. That has to have impacted you in all kinds of different ways. But you know, Govind, your group, Govind runs a women's empowerment group in Rajasthan, but one of the more controversial things that you have actually encouraged the women in this group to do is to be a vigilante group. In other words, some of you may have seen the movie Gulabi Gang. Madhuri was here earlier. These are women who basically carry lathis and, you know, they kind of hit back with violence. And you were telling me that you do on occasion promise instant justice. Are we saying to the women in this country that you have no option? The courts aren't going to help you. The cops aren't going to help you. So you have to pick up these, you know, sticks and stones and beat the men who abuse you. And isn't that a really, really, really dangerous path to walk us down?
See, I agree with you that it's a dangerous part. One thing is that I'm not very theoretical. I left my school at the age of 14 when my father died.
Yes.
I was pulled out of school.
Yeah.
So I don't know how many of you will agree to this. But I think agree to the thing that violence is sometimes the only answer to violence. I think it is a right for a woman to defend herself. And I'm trying to help, or we are trying to help them, how to defend themselves.
No, but self-defense is kind of different from saying, "I'll just go and kill my rapist."
No, no. So we train them in self-defensing. And then when sometimes we get calls, for instance, Sanju called me the other day and she said, Bhaiya, mera aadmi mujhe maar raha hai buri tarike se aur mujhe bahut khoon nikal raha hai, mere bacche dono dar gaye. I related herself to my mother and I related those children to me. And what would I do?
And what did you do?
And then I called Mrs. Mehta, who's our project coordinator, and I said, take the 20 of our women who are self-defended, go to the police station on the way and tell them that you're going to this house and you're bringing the guy to the police station. And agar police wala does not file a complaint against the guy,
then hit him too.
Then surround the police station and take the justice in your hand to make sure that Sanju's husband is behind bars within 24 hours, that he's not escaping or something like this.
So I want to hold you here, because while what he's saying captures the rawness of our response, and I know that if any, you know, for anyone who grew up in India, by the way, all of us women, when we used to take public transport to college, I think there isn't one of us who hasn't had our breasts pinched or our bottoms pinched or been leered at. I have memories of men actually just tripping in the bus that I used to take to, and you know, sort of in a gross sort of exhibitionist streak. And yes, indeed, often I slapped one of them. And sometimes I just say, well, you know, how many days am I going to slap them? And I know every woman in this room has been through something like this. So Madhavi, is this the answer? Are we actually saying this is the answer?
I think it's a long battle. Are we only celebrating victimhood or are we celebrating survival? And if you're celebrating survival, are we not falling into the same trap of the jati panchayats, of the kind of mediation and panchayats our families do with us, if we're going to take on violence and take on the same norms? So, I mean, that Constitution of India and those courts, they do give us a framework for the right to women to survive. And we are celebrating survival today. We're celebrating her survival to live. Definitely in that moment, you might have a reaction. But you know that violence is not the answer for violence.
You're saying it's a kind of kangaroo court response.
We had a case of a domestic violence in an upper caste family where the walls are thicker than, in fact, for Dalit families. Because in upper caste families, it's the dead body that comes out by the time they break the silence. I still feel that in upper class and caste families, the silence has not broken. In fact,
oh no.
Even
oh
with
no.
this, right? I mean, how many people in the room here today have the courage to speak the way Bitiya did? Or that, you know, the
Absolutely.
Way you did. So, I mean, I think the reaction to that violence and a whole journey, because these same children fought their case for 16 years against their father.
I think you make such an important point that actually being poor makes you more vulnerable, but it is the poor who speak out much more about sexual violence than those of us who are more privileged. I will allow you a brief interjection, because I know you were trying to say something, and then I want to go to Vibha and Menaka.
Thank you.
How long has been Bitiya waiting for her justice? How long?
What would you suggest she do, Govind?
No, I think that.
What should she do?
I think she should.
She wants to study.
Yeah, well, I think one organization should take her education. The other one should do something with her mother's livelihood.
Of course.
The third one should help her get as good legal aid as possible.
We agree with all of that.
As soon as possible.
We agree with all of that.
There are courts.
That we agree with. Yeah? If that's taking justice into your own hands, we agree with that. But how far do you push it? Now, Vibha, one of the things that happens to societies where women actually experience sexual abuse almost as a norm, and Menaka, you could speak to this as well, is that you get brutalized and numb to the point that you actually think it's a rites of passage. You know, we don't respond with horror to being molested on the streets. We don't, do we?
See, as I said, as a filmmaker, we are going to see a lot of stories of horror, and unfortunately, those are the only ones that make the headlines. But Bitiya's story is about change. The fact that they've spoken against such a strong system, that is change. The fact that the father and the grandfather are supporting it, that's the change. Now, it's our choice. I'm optimistic like you. As a stakeholder of society, I will cling on to hope. I hope we all cling on to hope. And I hope, I mean, I can understand the emotional outburst, but I just feel that if we empower the people who are already making change happen, as in motivating the system, and that includes the police, I I really never thought that the police across the country will be screening my film as part of the gender sensitization, whether they like it or not. But they are the toughest critics who've embraced the film. So you know what? I could have taken a stand, as in created notorious headlines out of the police station, or brought them on our side and said, you know what? Let's all be part of change. We can't do without them.
Okay.
And so here we are. I will cling
on
to it.
But you know, Menaka, my question was a little, you know, what I want you to speak to is how, because we know that what happened to Bitiya could happen to any one of us.
Yes.
When the ultimate depravity is not inflicted on us, and it's a bottom pincher,
sure.
And we've had, you know, jokes about bottom pinchers in this country, right?
Yeah,
we think it's a minor thing. Now, when I say we, I mean it's a sort of cultural construct. I don't mean the four people, five people on this stage. And we cannot get our parliamentarians, even in a parliament and even at a time when the Congress party was headed by a woman, to recognize marital rape.
I think that's right. You've also had politicians who've justified rape, saying ladkon se aise galtiyan ho jati hai. Well-known politicians close to Delhi. So you know, you have a political class, with a few exceptions, who strongly opposed the criminalization of marital rape. Why is that important?
That included women. We have to underline that included women.
That included men and women.
Yeah.
And why is that important? Because to recognize marital rape as an offense is an important step towards unpacking Indian masculinity and what young children are seeing in their homes. Because this is a cycle of violence. Look, the official numbers by the Ministry of Home Affairs, and Barkha and I were chatting about this, is that last year there were only 36,729 rapes in this country of almost 1.2 billion people. It is a severe case of underreporting, right? And we're not in the Chinese business of, you know, making up numbers to make ourselves look good, right? It tells you that the police are not registering complaints.
That people are not coming forward
to
register.
People are not
them.
Coming forward, but Barkha, there has been a sea change.
There is a change.
In terms of survivors.
Yeah.
That has changed. Bitiya is here.
Yeah.
You know?
The biggest change I would say is that people, women, are willing to tell their stories.
Yes.
Yes, so women are willing to tell their stories. We have to meet them.
Where do you come in on the vigilante justice that Govind is talking about?
Look, I am committed to the idea that the legal framework and the constitution has to provide the answers here. We have a broken legal system. As people, as citizens of this country, you have to expect better. You have to pressurize your politicians. You have to pressurize your lawmakers. You have to pressurize your cops. That's the way to make change. If we, you know, take the easier way out, which is let's beat back, then we actually lose everything, because there's not very much then that differentiates us from them. And that's all we have left.
Govind, go back to being that child. Now, as a child, I can understand the child under the bed who's seeing his mother being clobbered, that you feel violence towards the man who's doing this to your mother, even though that man happens to be your father. But as you grow older, as we reflect on our first instincts and don't always act on them, right? I understand it as a first instinct. Even I'd want to kill somebody. Yeah. I'm using the word kill. My first response was I'd want to kill a rapist.
Sure.
I'd want to kill a molester. But as we reflect on our first instinct, what are we telling women in this country? Are you telling Bitiya, you're never going to get justice in the court, you may as well get a gang of women and men in the village together and go and hang these men at the town square? It's a bit scary. I don't know what to make of what you're suggesting.
See, what I have done in the past 9 years devoting my life to this charity that I founded, it had been successful in a small city like Jodhpur, where just because of danda at the police station, our cases were filed.
Explain danda at the police station. Do you just hold the danda? Do you use the danda? Like, can you explain this?
We hold the danda at the police station, and we make sure that danda is there, and they write the FIRs and all. And if they don't do the FIRs and all, then danda also gets raised.
Well, it's so interesting. I think I just saw Madhuri walk in, and we were just talking about the Gulabi gang kind of justice, Madhuri.
We were 365 people to see Gulabi gang that day. next day we started self-defense courses, and it was you were but our inspiration.
But is
in this
movie? But you know, great thing. Film. But yes. Is that the answer? I'm just saying, what are we telling women in this? Women here today, Madhavi.
I think we're telling them these stories. And I think the police is changing because of these stories, because of the stories of truth. And I just want to say that even while the media, films, everyone's taking it up, we all know that this battle starts from when that FIR is registered. It's does that Bitiya didn't have to leave her village like many girls who get raped and has to leave her
but
village.
But she had to leave her school.
So that, but she went back. She went back. That's the point. She had to leave her school. She went back. The point is the struggle begins from the day you open your mouth, and it doesn't end there. That's the day the struggle begins. A struggle to make a new life, to celebrate survival, to be accepted, not just on this stage, but as
Madhavi,
a friend.
Madhavi, since it's my job to play contrarian, we are in a country where I'm going on saying Nirbhaya. I am not even taking her name. How are we going to change when we can't name the victim or name the survivor because of stigma? What are we saying? Why is the stigma that of the victim?
Exactly. But the people who are standing up there and doing this struggle and fighting, and if the media would talk more about the survival, the long court battles, not forget it then, and remember 10 years later that you're still fighting and how you're struggling. I mean, which job did you get? Who married you and who didn't marry you?
Yeah.
Where did you have to get married?
Fair enough.
Why is marriage so central to everybody's life, for instance?
Yeah.
If people would even think about that.
Oh, yeah.
Rather
and,
than
and,
using
and,
a gender.
Madhavi, so, I'm so glad you brought that up, because even the opposition to recognizing marital rape is this entire premium on marriage. And you had ministers saying, oh, we can't break up the family, as if to suggest that it's worth preserving a family in which the woman gets sexually abused, clobbered. I don't know what kind of marriage that is. Okay, we have 30 seconds for all of you.
So 1 second.
30 seconds.
Doesn't it all come down to how we are thinking? So it's all about us again. All these biases and values and whatever we are carrying, this extra baggage with us, it all comes down to us. And that's what's getting reflected in how we're thinking.
But you know what, Menaka, since you're a lawyer, some of you may know that we do finally have a new rape law.
Yes,
it has been applied in several high profile cases recently.
Yes, that's right.
And how did we get a sexual harassment set of guidelines? We got it from a woman called Bhavri Devi.
Yeah.
Again, a Dalit woman, more than 2 decades ago, gang raped. It was one of the first stories I did as a young reporter. I started out with that story. And I see my life from then to now. I started with the gang rape of Bhavri Devi. I'm now doing Nirbhaya. Bhavri from 20 years ago,
yeah.
22 years now, has not got justice. Does that make you pause and think maybe Govind is right?
It makes me... Well, I think it should make us sad. I think it should make us angry. But I think if you give up on the law, then you are giving up on the promise of this country. Be clear about that. And if you give up on the promise of India, then yes, we can all go out and settle scores as has been done traditionally. But remember, this act of violence is also a traditional act of violence.
Yeah.
So respond as citizens of this country and demand better. When a politician says this is how men behave, then make sure you vote him out of office.
Or
when
her.
When a sitting minister says, you know, Hindu women need to produce more and more children, then make those words count.
Yeah, you know? I do. I just want to say in the end, if Nirbhaya's parents are here, then we thank you for shedding a light on this spot of darkness. I was told they're here. I'm not sure they are. But if you are here, if you're listening to this, thank you. And finally, thank you to Bitiya, because I do agree with what's been said, that there was a time 10 years ago when you would not have had a Dalit girl traveling from Uttar Pradesh to sit in the Taj Mansingh Hotel and tell her story of her gang rape and her fight and her simple dream, I want to study. And I think from that story...
Can I put in a request? Everyone in this room walked that long battle with any domestic violence or sexual assault survivor. If you just walked with them, not just read about them and spoke about them, but also now walked with them.
Yes.
We find that dream of India, really.
Thank you so much. Thank you.